It's a journalistic cliche. Send a reporter to a sensitive public building and test just how good the security is. Sometimes it can expose a major failing that puts the public at risk. But a recent spate of testing stories raises the question of when the media goes too far.
This months-old video shows two men parachuting off New York's new World Trade Center tower. The breathtaking stunt pointed to a breathtaking lapse in security. So when two CNN producers tried this week to test if security had improved, they were immediately caught and tossed in the clink. Sometimes that's worth the risk.
We went into this knowing that we could be arrested.
Such as when just a year after the September 11th attacks, New York Daily News reporters caused a sensation after successfully sneaking box cutters onto 14 different flights.
If U.S. Customs scanners cannot detect this, they won't detect the real thing, the highly enriched uranium.
That depleted uranium was sneaked through the port of Los Angeles not once but twice by ABC's Brian Ross in a story about lax screening of shipping containers. The feds were not amused.
Five federal agents showed up demanding to see me, the producers, and the depleted uranium.
More recently, school security has been the test du jour.
Today, we tested the security systems at five local schools.
Earlier this year, KSDK in St. Louis sent a reporter into five schools to see just how far he could get before being stopped. The stunt triggered a lockdown at one local high school, and the station got an earful from angry parents.
Quite honestly, it doesn't matter what our intentions were. We caused undue stress and fear, and we are very sorry this happened.
Just like the two CNN reporters who can now report that, yes, security at the World Trade Center site appears quite improved.
It seems almost inherent to me that these tests involve a breaking or bending of rules and quite often a breaking of the law. Is it appropriate for someone to commit a criminal act in order to test the security at a school or in an airport or a public place?
Well, no. I mean, to in a word, absolutely not. And, you know, the First Amendment does not exempt the media from generally applicable laws, which is, I think, the legal language that the courts use. And, you know, if the authorities were inclined to throw the book at anybody who was doing what the two CNN producers did at the World Trade Center tower, then I suppose that they would be perfectly all right with throwing the book at these two CNN producers. I mean, this is, I know that we looked at other examples there, but CNN just stands out these days as the news network that just can't get anything right, from their obsession with the airliner crash to repeatedly making high-profile mistakes that they have to apologize for, and now this. I mean, it's just completely unwarranted, and
I don't think they'd have more sense than that.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Dan, I wouldn't draw the line exactly where you do. I think there are occasions, there are certain kinds of stories where you might have to bend certain rules. And, you know, we get into the whole issue of stolen documents and the Pentagon Papers and, oh, yes, the Snowden cases, which definitely come into that area where the media has to look at whether they're stepping over the line, whether they're breaking any laws. And they're not always easy choices.
Well, I'm sorry, but the media has not been stealing documents. They've been consulting stolen documents, but they did not steal them.
Well, I certainly agree, but not everyone does. You know, there are interpretations of that dissemination of stolen information that this is also against the law. And we'll could see some prosecutions at some point. But that, you know, I just think it's worth saying that if it's a gimmicky kind of story, you know, we all sort of know what that is, when the motivation out there is not so much to solve a local problem, but to get the reporters in a situation where they look like they know what they're doing, that, which doesn't always happen. That I think that's the thing I look for, and I think there are certain cases where rules need to be broken to get a great story.
It becomes a stunt at some point.
It certainly does.
Well, it is a stunt. I mean, you know that.
Correct.
I mean, that's the point of it all, and I think the bottom line is what Bob Steele said at the Poynter Institute, which is a school for journalists 100 years ago. If the story ends up being about the activity more than the point you're trying to make with regard to the security or whatever you're testing, that's the bottom line. And so all of these pretty much did that. They focused attention on themselves.
I don't know. If you're showing that, you know, a year after September 11th, anyone can just walk onto, you know, a number of airplane flights and carry box cutters, that strikes me as meaningful journalism. I think there's a fine line, though, between highlighting a threat that is genuine and that the government's been remiss in taking seriously, and kind of suggesting that something which really isn't a threat is something that everyone should be terrified about, like, for example, strangers walking into schools. I mean, I think, you know, in the wake of Newtown, obviously, that's a terrifying prospect to contemplate. The odds of it happening are, I think, incredibly slim. So I don't know exactly how you draw the line between legitimate issues and sort of gratuitous fear-mongering, but as you said, I think you kind of know it when you see it. To me, walking into a school feels like gratuitous fear-mongering. Well, showing that box cutters can be brought onto planes is I think, you know, even if it results in legal punishment, I think it's commendable.
I assume that there are more legitimate ways of reporting these important stories. I'm not saying they're not.
But how else do you show that you can bring lethal weapons onto planes a year after September 11th?
Well, maybe you work with authorities on reporting that story.
But you're trying to show
that off on your own.
But you're trying to show the negligence of the authorities. I mean, I don't know how you know, if you get a tip from a member of TSA or something who says we have caught. You know, 50 people have brought this stuff on planes, and we only found them after the fact. That's great, but if you don't have that tip, I don't have a problem with them doing that.
Isn't
well,
there
I think
a question?
We want to just make the point that,
sure.
Which has been made by others, is that you need to do some reporting before your first report should not be, let's walk into the school and see what happens. So let's look
and
at some
cause a lockdown.
Exactly. Let's see how many times have people been arrested for walking into schools. Let's see who they were, what
That's
areas.
A good criteria.
This is what I'm saying. So let's do some reporting before we get there. With regard to the World Trade Center, how many people are trying to leap off or get in or whatever? That becomes more relevant after that 16-year-old, did tried it. So now it's like, okay, wait a minute. This is like the third time somebody just wandered in there. So that, to me, however CNN did it, was still, interesting in the way that they were trying to figure out what's going on here.
Perhaps it makes sense to remember the old saying, safety first, and a little common sense goes a long way.